चैप्टर 20 टेक्स्ट नंबर 34 ऑनवर्ड्स 34 टू 39 इन दिस सेक्शन द डिस्कशन इज अबाउट द स्टोरी ऑफ भारद्वाज द बर्थ ऑफ भारद्वाज एंड ही वाज द अडॉप्टेड सन ऑफ भरत डिस्कस अबाउट भरत द सन ऑफ दुष्यंत एंड शकुंतला ओके गुड तस्यासन्नृपवैदर्भ्य पत्नयस्तिस्रः सुसम्मता जघ्नुस्त्यागभयात् पुत्रान् नानुरूपा इतीरिते तस्य ऑफ हिम महाराज भरत आसन देयर वर नृप ओ किंग महाराज परीक्षित वैदर्भ्य डॉटर्स ऑफ वैदर्भ पत्नियः वाइव्स तिस्रः थ्री सुसम्मताः वेरी प्लीजिंग एंड सूटेबल जग्नुः किल्ड त्याग भयात फियरिंग रिजेक्शन पुत्रान देयर सन्स न अनुरूपः नॉट एग्जैक्टली लाइक द फादर इति लाइक दिस ई रीते कंसीडरिंग This is 34 shloka of chapter 20 of canto 9.20.34 Translation and purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada Srila Prabhupada ki jai Sorry to go here. Okay. Translation. O King Parikshit. Nirpa. O King Parikshit. Tasya tisraha susammataha. Maharaj Bharat. Tasya had three pleasing wives. Tasya tisraha susammataha. Patnyas asan. Patnyas asan. He had three pleasing wives. Who were the daughters of the king of Vaidarbha. Vaidarbha means These three daughters were king of Vaidarbha. Na anurupa iti irite. Na anurupa. When the king said the sons did not resemble him. The wives, fearing rejection, tyaga bhayat, killed their own sons. Putran jagnuhu. O King Parikshit, Maharaj Bharat had three pleasing wives who were daughters of the king of Vaidarbha. When all three of them bore children who did not resemble the king, these wives thought that he would consider them unfaithful queens and reject them. And therefore, they killed their own sons. Okay. तस्यैवं वितथेवं से तदर्थं यजतः सुतं मरुत्स्तोमेन मरुतो भरद्वाजं उपाददुः तस्य हिज महाराज भरत एवं दस वितथे बीइंग बेफल्ड वंशे इन जनरेटिंग प्रोजेनी तदर्थं टू गेट सन्स यजतः परफॉर्मिंग सैक्रिफाइसेस सुतं ए सन मरुत्स्तोमेन By performing a Marut Stom sacrifice, Marutaha, the demigods named the Maruts, Bharadvajam, Bharadvaj, Upadadhu, present. The king, his attempt for progeny frustrated in this way, performed a sacrifice named Marut Stoma to get a son. The demigods known as the Maruts, being fully satisfied with him, then presented him a son named Bharadvaj. Okay, so for continuing his lineage, this king Bharat performed a sacrifice to the Maruts. Maruts are the same demigods, you remember, we read that in the 6th canto, okay, Diti's son, 49 Maruts. So the Maruts were pleased and they brought and gave him a son named Bharadvaj. Okay, so who was Bharadvaj now? That's the point. Okay. So now Bharadwaj, who is Bharadwaj? So that is the now next verse will explain who is Bharadwaj. Okay. Okay. 36. So next few shlokas will talk about Bharadwaj. Okay. Who is Bharadwaj? Antarvatnayam bhratripatnyam maithunaya brihaspatihi pravritto varito garvam saptva viryam upasrijat. Antahavatnayam pregnant bhratripatnyam with the brother's wife maithunaya desiring sexual enjoyment brihaspatihi, the demigod named Brihaspati, pravrittaha, so inclined, varitaha, when forbidden to do so, garbham, the son within the abdomen, shaptva, by cursing, viryam, semen, upasriya, discharge. When the demigod named Brihaspati was attracted by his brother's wife, Mamata, who at that time was pregnant, he desired to have sexual relations with her. The son within her womb forbade this, but Brihaspati cursed him and forcibly discharged semen into the womb of Mamata. Purport. The sex impulse is so strong in this material world that even Brihaspati, who is supposed to be the priest of the demigods and a very learned scholar, wanted to have a sexual relationship with his brother's pregnant wife. So this Prabhupada is bringing our attention that this thing is very, very strong, so we have to be very careful. Okay, very strong impulse comes that even the Brihaspati, he is like priest for the devatas, for the demigods, right? So it's very powerful thing, but still one can overcome it by engaging the senses in the service of Krishna. Okay, so Haridas Thakur was also chanting all the time, 3 lakhs name per day. And then this Muslim king sent a prostitute to disturb Haridas Thakur. But Haridas Thakur was not disturbed because he was engaged in chanting Hare Krishna. So he followed the rules properly. He was very much focused towards his devotional service, and holy name protected him. Holy name is so powerful. Among all the tapa and all the names of chanting, and the chanting of the names of Krishna is most powerful and can protect from all sorts of lusty things, all sorts of dangerous things. Dangerous means which are dangerous for our spiritual progress. Okay, so that is very, very important point. Okay, so that's why Prabhupada is saying that this can happen even in the society of the higher demigods. Okay, even in the society of higher demigods. So what to speak of a human society? The sex impulse is so strong that it can agitate even a learned personality like Brihaspati. Very, very dangerous thing it is. Okay, so this verse explains about Bharadwaj, that Brihaspati desired union with Mamata. She was actually the wife of his brother Uthaya. When the child in the womb, at that time she was pregnant, so the child in the womb shouting forbade him, since there was no space for 2 children there. So Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur writing here that Brihaspati cursed him in anger, become blind. He then by force impregnated her. So Brihaspati cursed him. It's very, very the lust is so much powerful that it can blind even the learned personality like Brihaspati and made him shameless and like that. It's too bad. The story then 37, and further it will explain. Tam tektu kamam mamatam भर्तुस्त्याग विशंकितां नाम निर्वाचनं तस्य श्लोकं एनं सुराजगुः तम दैट न्यूली बॉर्न बेबी त्यक्तु कामां हु वाज ट्राइंग टू अवॉइड ममताम अंटु ममता भर्तु त्याग विशंकितां वेरी मच अफ्रेड ऑफ बीइंग फॉरसेकन बाय हर हस्बैंड बिकॉज ऑफ गिविंग बर्थ टू एन इलीजिटिमेट सन नाम निर्वाचनम ए नेम गिविंग सेरेमनी और नामकरण तस्या टू द चाइल्ड श्लोकम वर्स एनम दिस सुरहा द डेमिगॉड जगहु एनन्सिएटेड सो that son who was inside the womb, he tried to stop Brihaspati, but Brihaspati cursed him that you become blind, and forcefully he did that. So Mamta very much feared being forsaken by her husband for giving birth to an illegitimate son, and therefore she considered giving up the child. But then the demigod solved the problem by enunciating a name for the child. Purport. According to the Vedic scripture, whenever a child is born, there are some ceremonies known as Jatakarma and Namakarana, in which learned Brahmanas, immediately after the birth of the child, make a horoscope according to astrological calculations. But the child to which Mamata gave birth was begotten by Brihaspati irreligiously. For although Mamata was the wife of Uttaya, Brihaspati made her pregnant by force. Therefore, Brihaspati became Bharata. According to Vedic culture, a wife is considered the property of her husband, and a son born by illicit sex is called Dwaj. Okay, that's how the name comes. Okay, so wife is the property of her husband, but a son, if is born by illicit relationship, that son is called Dwaj. The common word is still current in Hindu society for such a son is dogla, okay, which refers to a, so it comes from there only, so which refers to a son not begotten by the husband of his mother. Okay, dogla means a son not begotten by the husband of his mother. Okay, in such a situation, it is difficult to give the child a name according to proper regulative principles. Mamata therefore was perplexed, but the demigods gave the child the appropriate name Bharadwaj, which indicated that the child born illegitimately should be maintained by both Mamata and Brihaspati. Okay, so from the curse of Brihaspati, the child Dirghatma was born blind, the first child. That child in the womb kicked the semen of Brihaspati with his heel, and it fell from the womb of Mamata on the ground. It immediately took the form of child. Mamata desired to reject the child, that child produced from another man. The devatas then recited a verse to Mamata, who feared rejection by her husband. The verse was a talk between Brihaspati and Mamata. The verse gives the child a name Bharadwaj. Okay. मूढ़े भरद्वाजम इमं भरद्वाजम बृहस्पते यातौ यद उक्त्वा पितरौ भरद्वाजस्ततस्तु अयम् तव अयम् मूढ़े ओ फूलिश वुमेन भरत जस्ट मेंटेन द्वाजम आल्दो बोर्न बाय एन इलिसिट कनेक्शन बिटवीन टू इमं दिस चाइल्ड भरत मेंटेन द्वाजम आल्दो बोर्न बाय एन इलिसिट कनेक्शन बिटवीन टू Brihaspati, O Brihaspati, Yato left yet because Uktva having said, Pitaro, both the father and mother, Bharadwaja, by the name Bharadwaja, Tata, thereafter, tu, indeed, I am this child. Okay. So Brihaspati said to Mamata, you foolish woman, although this child was born from the wife of one man through the semen discharge by another, you should maintain him. Upon hearing this, Mamata replied, O Brihaspati, you maintain him. After speaking in this way, Brihaspati and Mamata both left. Thus the child was known as Bharadwaj. So Brihaspati said to Mamata, who was going away leaving the child. So Brihaspati said to, she was leaving. Oh fool, you should maintain this child, but I fear, so she may say that I fear my husband. Though he is born from the semen of another man in your womb, though he is twice born, he is born from both of us. He is your child, therefore you should not fear your husband. So Mamata said, O Brahaspati, you should maintain him because he was born wrongly from two fathers. By force you have produced this child in me, though I was unwilling. He is your son, not mine. Because both the mother and father went away, he was called Bharadwaj. Maintain the son produced by two fathers. Another version has somewhere else mentioned, Yad Dukha, the mother and the father left in sorrow on giving up their son. Okay, so that's how the name came, Bharadwaj. 39. Chodyamana surairevam matva vitatham atmajam vishrajan maruto abhibran datto ayam vitathe anvaye. Chodyamana, although Mamata was encouraged to maintain the child, surai, by the demigods, evam in this way, matva, considering vitatham, purposeless, atmajam, her own child, vesrajat, rejected, marutah, the demigods known as the Maruts, Abhivran, maintained the child, Dattaha, the same child was given, I am this, Vitathe was disappointed, Anvaye, when the dynasty of Maharaj Bharat. Okay, so a story is like this, and they both did not want, so demigods said to Mamata and Bharata that you should maintain it. And then, although encouraged by the demigods to maintain the child, Mamata considered him useless because of his illicit birth. And therefore she left him. Even though demigods said, no, you can maintain and his name can be Bharadwaj, like that. But she left him. Consequently, the demigods known as the Maruts maintained the child. And when Maharaj Bharat was disappointed for want of a child, the child was given to him as his son. Okay, so the same child was given to Maharaj Bharat as the son. From this verse, it is understood that those who are rejected from the higher planetary system are given a chance to take birth in the most exalted families on this planet Earth. Okay, so people who are rejected from there, they are still very high, that in this Earth, planet Earth, they get a very exalted family. Okay, so Vishnachakri Chagu says here that the devatas encouraged her in a joking way. O Mamata, follow the order of Brahaspati, your paramour. Thinking the child useless, Mamata, out of embarrassment, abandoned the child. Okay, she gave up the child born of Brahaspati. The Maruts raised the child, she abandoned. After accepting him, when Bharat's lineage was interrupted, they gave the child to Bharat. Thus ends the Bhakti Vedanta purports of the 9th canto, 20th chapter of the Srimad Bhagavatam, entitled The Dynasty of Puru. Okay? Chapter number 21.